फ्रेंड, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल टेक डब्ल्यू थ्री वेव। दिस इज विजय कुमार। टेक डब्ल्यू थ्री वेव इट इज ए प्लेटफॉर्म वेयर यू कैन लर्न स्टेप बाय स्टेप ऑल अबाउट द सेल्सफोर्स एप्लीकेशन एंड डेवलपमेंट। इन दिस ट्यूटोरियल यू विल बी लर्न अवर फ्रेमवर्क LWC, अपेक्स क्लास ट्रिगर, विजुअल फोर्स एंड मेनी मोर। सो नाउ लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। In this lesson, we will be learn about how to create custom lightning spinner to show, hide, and toggle on click button in LWC component. So, friends, follow these steps to achieve the scenario. We need to follow three type of steps: step number one, step number two, and step number three. In the step number one, first we need to create lightning app. Here I created my lightning app. This is a custom app. Then go to the step number two. In the step number two, click on the gear icon. You will be get edit page. Once click on the edit page, we will be move on the step number three. In the step number three, we will be call my LWC component to the custom app. So in the LWC component, I created three type of button. Either is a spinner. Once click on the show spinner, spinner will be display. When I click on the hide spinner, spinner will be hide. If I click on the toggle spinner, first it will be show. If I click it once again on the same button on the toggle spinner, the spinner will be hide. So here we will be learn about how to show, hide and toggle of custom lightning spinner in LWC component. So friends, now let me move on the Salesforce org, where we will be see live demo scenario how to create a custom spinner to show, hide and toggle in LWC component. So now let's get started. So friends, this is my Salesforce credential org. I open my LWC component to the Lightning Studio. This is my LWC component. This is a component JavaScript. This is a meta XML file. This is a Lightning component application. Here I calling my LWC component to preview the component into the browser. This is a style CSS. So friends, this is my LWC component. In the LWC component, first I created a Lightning card. Then I created a div. And after this div, I created another one div. Inside the div, I created a H3. This is a title of the page. So you can see in the title, first I displaying icon. After that icon, after that icon, I created a title of the page. The title of the page is display spinner I show, hide and toggle in Lightning web component LWC. This is a title of the page. After H3, I created a lightning button. So here you can see there are three lightning button I have created. Each and every button I passing on the click event, that is a different function. So here you can see this is a button for the show spinner. This is a button for the hide spinner. This is a button for the toggle spinner. And each and every button I pass on click function to show, hide and toggle the spinner. So here you can see after H3 I created three type of lightning button. After this button I created another one div. Inside the div I applying template. So in the template I am creating a if condition, and in the if condition I checking a spinner status. This is a boolean type variable that is defined in the JavaScript file. So by default it is a false. When it's get true, then spinner will be displayed. So this is a spinner. First I created a div. Inside the div I created a section. Inside the section I created a lightning spinner. This is a lightning spinner element that is provided by the Salesforce. So based on this lightning spinner element, I will be creating a spinner. So this is a variant brand, alternative text loading. And after the section, I am creating a div. And this is a SLDS backdrop, and SLDS backdrop open to fading the gray color below the pop-up. So friends, here I am creating lightning spinner. So lightning spinner will be open in the model pop-up. So below the model pop-up, I will display the gray color of the backdrop. This is a class that is provided by the Salesforce. So now let me move on to the JavaScript file. So this is a JavaScript file. So in the JavaScript file, friends, first I created a @API decorator variable. This is a spinner status. So by default I am passing false. Once it gets false, then it will be hide. But if I passing the true, then it will be display the model pop-up in the LWC component. So in the JavaScript part, here I can see there are three functions I created. First function is a toggle spinner, second function is a show spinner, and third function is a hide spinner. So each and every button I pass a different type of the function. Function name is a show spinner, hide spinner, and toggle spinner. So all of the functions I created in the JavaScript file here. So friends, this function using for the toggle, this function using for the show spinner. So in this function I am using the this dot spinner status equal to true. This is a height spinner function. So in the height spinner function I am passing false value. So once it gets false, then model pop-up will be height. So inside the model pop-up I will be display the spinner. And this is a toggle function. So once click on the button, first it will be get true. Once click again in this button, then the value will be gets false. So in the JavaScript file, I create three type of function for the show, hide and toggle. This is a meta XML file. So friends, in the meta XML file, I applying targets and targets. So in the target, I applying app page, record page and home page. So all of this page, this component will be visual. Then here you can see I created a order component application. So here I am calling my LWC component into the Lightning application. Here this is my component name. This is a Lightning application. So inside the Lightning application, I am calling my LWC component. And this is a style CSS. So friends, in the style CSS, I added a class. The class name is button over W3B. This class name I am calling into the Lightning order component here. So friends, in the style CSS, I am adding a property position absolute, z index and display block. So friends, now let me move on the Salesforce code where I will be open my Lightning application. This is my Salesforce code. Here you can see I created my Lightning application and inside Lightning application I call my LWC component. This is a preview. Once click on the preview, the Lightning application open into the browser. Here you can see in the component I create three type of button: show spinner, hide spinner and toggle spinners. Once click on the toggle spinner, model pop-up will be show and inside the model pop-up will be display the custom spinner. So now let's click on the show spinner first. Here you can see pop-up open and inside the pop-up the custom spinner display. Once I click on the hide spinner, the spinner will be hide. So friends, now let's me click on the hide spinner. Here you can see after click on the hide spinner, the model pop-up automatically hide. Now click on the toggle spinner. So when I click on the toggle spinner, first it will be show. Once I click again the same button, it will be hide. So why using the toggle button? So friends, by clicking on the toggle spinner, it will be show and hide the spinner. So friends, in this lesson we have learned how to create custom spinner as a show, hide and toggle in LWC component. Friends, if you find value in my content, consider making a small donation to support the channel. Friends, as you know, my content is designed to guide you step by step through real world scenario. I am ensuring friends you get practical and hands-on experience inside the tutorial. Friends, if my video bringing value to your learning journey, consider making a small donation to support the continued creation of high quality tutorial for you. Your small donation will motivate me to produce even more in-depth content for you. Friends, I would like to a special thank to everyone for a small donation to support the channel. Friends, after making a small donation, please send me your donation screenshot on my email or WhatsApp. I will send you an exclusive ebook bonus gift with advanced Salesforce tips, tricks, and strategy to take your skill to the next level. So friends, by donating, you are not just investing in only your own growth, you are contributing to the success of countless others as well. So friends, here you are thinking, after donating, what you are will be get bonus as a gift. So now let me explain about what you will be get bonus after donating and support to me. Friends, scan QR code from here and make a small donation to support the channel. After support the channel, please share your screenshot on my email or WhatsApp so that we can send you an exclusive bonus gift on your email. So friends, here you can see I will be sending you bonus gift as two ebook. These are the books you are very powerful in the Salesforce. First ebook you are Master of Effects Trigger and second ebook you are Salesforce Tutorial. So friends, both of the ebook published on Amazon. If you check on the Amazon, this is the Effects Trigger and this is a Salesforce Tutorial. So friends, the Effects Trigger, the price on the Amazon is 333 rupees and Salesforce Tutorial, the price on Amazon is 199 rupees. So both of the ebook I will provide as a bonus gift after donating and support to this channel. फ्रेंड्स, सो दीज आर द ई बुक यू विल बी गेट आफ्टर डोनेटिंग एंड सपोर्टिंग टू द चैनल। सो फ्रेंड्स, आफ्टर डोनेटिंग ए स्मॉल अमाउंट टू द चैनल, प्लीज शेयर योर स्क्रीनशॉट ऑन दिस ईमेल आईडी एंड यू कैन शेयर योर स्क्रीनशॉट ऑन व्हाट्सएप ऑन दिस फोन नंबर। सो फ्रेंड्स, आफ्टर मेकिंग ए स्मॉल डोनेशन टू दिस चैनल, आई विल बी शेयर बोथ ऑफ द ई बुक ऑन योर ईमेल सो दैट यू विल बी गेट सो मेनी tips, trick and strategy in the sales force. So friends, let's grow together, watch, donate and start your journey to get success by today. Friends, if you want to soft copy code of all files, check on description of this video. In the description of this video, I will provide live demo scenarios link so that you can simply copy and paste to create functionality in your personal org. And you will be save lot of time, energy and effort. Friends, you can also schedule a meeting with me. I will provide schedule meeting link in the description of this video. If you are struggling any kind of issue during development, schedule meeting with me. I will help you to resolve the issue. You will be get schedule meeting link in the description of this video. You can schedule meeting with me as per your availability, date and time. Thank you.